In most African countries, pretty much everyone either employs a domestic worker, is related to a domestic worker, or is a domestic worker. They're mostly women, many of them young girls, commonly referred to as house girls. But how much do employers even think about who their maids really are or where they come from?
The problem with domestic workers is they work in a hidden industry because you see they live in people's private households, closed doors and closed walls. So they work in slavery-like conditions.
In this film, we're going to shed some light on the secret lives of housegirls. We're in eastern Uganda, close to the border with Kenya. The villages on both sides of the border supply many of neighboring Kenya's domestic workers. It's here that we meet two sisters. Esther is 21 and plans to leave for Kenya's capital, Nairobi, to find work as a housemaid.
Maisha Nairobi ni afadhali kuliko hapa.
Yeah, nimeona juu huko unaweza pata pesa lakini ukikaa huko uweza hata pata ya kukula, hata ya kununua kitu uvaa uweza pata. Kazi iko lakini pesa ya huko ni kidogo. Si unajua huko wanakupatia just 30 per month. Sasa hiyo pesa uwezi subiri na hiyo. Tunaendanga huko juu tunapata pesa mzuri huko. Huko Nairobi. Kama umepata kazi mzuri, maisha inakuanga poa.
Esther's elder sister Juliet is 24. She's already been to Nairobi as a domestic worker and earned enough money to build a new family home.
Nataka kurudi lakini kwanza nataka wanitafutie kazi, kazi ikipatikana ndio niende. Nikukosa tu fare lakini ingeenda.
While Juliet did make money in Nairobi, the experience was a painful one.
Ndienda kwenda hawezi nipatia chakula. Mwezi ikifika umuitishe pesa yako, anakutusi, anakuambia mimi nitakuua kwa nyumba yangu, atienda. Mwingine anifukuza, huyo tu alinifukuza usiku. Unaweza tafuta upate boss mzuri ama upate mbaya. Ukipata mbaya uweze vumilia kukaa na yeye, unatoka.
Lakini bado hiyo inafadhali kuliko kukaa hapa.
Naweza kaa kutoka asubuhi mchanga lakini sioni hata kitu. Ndio nimesema wacha niende huko. Tafadhali ufanye wakupatie kitu.
Kila siku basi zinapitisha watu, zinapeleka huko Nairobi. Basi zinapita 3 kwa siku.
Esther and Juliet's parents have struggled to provide for their 7 children. They've managed to raise just enough money for Esther's bus ticket though. She's packing to leave tonight. All along the border, the villagers are giving up their daughters in this new wave of migration. Money made in Kenya can go a long way here, thanks to the strength of the Kenyan shilling against Uganda's currency. In another Ugandan village along the border, a local leader introduces me to Euphrasia Juma. She lives alone, surviving on the harvest from a small plot of cassava and a jackfruit tree. Her only granddaughter, named Scovia, got on a bus 2 months ago and left to find work in Nairobi, like many other young girls in this area. Scovia is an orphan. Her parents were buried in the compound.
Mama Sikofya, bamule hano mwaka mulala. Uwera ndi siengene, mumo mundu na honi.
Kuyo hapa baba wa Sikofya?
Aha, liyaona. Hata, alikufa, nini, accident.
Kwa ni uu ni mke wa? Alikufa na nini?
Ugonjwa.
Euphrasia has been worried. Scovia was just 17 and had never even left the village before the family cobbled enough money together for her bus ticket to Nairobi. Poverty and the lack of opportunities around them. These are the reasons why so many girls from these villages seek hope in a city far away. Nairobi is 450 kilometers away from the Ugandan border. The city is the beating heart of commerce in Kenya and a cosmopolitan hub for the East African region. It's estimated that there are 1 million domestic workers in Nairobi. Many of them come to the city from rural parts of Kenya, but increasingly from neighboring countries too. There is free movement between Kenya and Uganda for visits of up to 3 months. But the girls coming from Uganda often don't even have a passport or identity card, and they don't obtain the visas that would allow them to work in Kenya legally.
The girls slip in easily through the porous borders and are connected to employers by relatives or just people they know. Many of the girls arrive here in Nairobi with nothing more than the phone number of the person who sent for them and very little knowledge of just how difficult the life they're about to enter might turn out to be.
The city's informal settlements absorb a large proportion of the new workers. They're the only places most domestic workers can afford to live, and where Ugandan girls seek accommodation when they arrive.
I received a call from Esther. She told me she's arrived in Nairobi, and this is where she's staying. So I'm going to go and find out how her job search is going.
Esther is sharing with three other young Ugandans to keep costs down. They're splitting the $15 a month rent between them.
Hi, Esther.
It's a corrugated iron structure and baking hot inside. They have no electricity and share a single mattress.
Utatumia jinsi gani kutafuta kazi?
Najua iko rafiki yetu mwingine, ule Juliet anakuanga anaishi na yeye huko. Akona marafiki wengi huko, ndio yeye ndiye anatafutanga kazi, anasikianga kazi na wewe pia. Mala na anafanya, anaweza kusikia, na mimi pia, mimi mwenyewe nitakuwa natembea kutafuta. Nifike kwa nyumba niulize kama iko mtu anataka mtu kufanya kazi.
Esther would prefer to find a job like her roommate Rachel's, but they're hard to come by.
Nilikuwa nafanya kwa hoteli.
Ipi ndio nzuri, kazi ya hoteli au kazi ya nyumbani?
Lakini hao wanalipanga kila siku, na ya nyumba ya mwezi tu.
Unajua kwa hoteli unakulanga, chai unakunywa, na kwa nyumba, huwezi pata hata chai. Lakini huyu mwenye anafanya ule bosi yake, nimemuona ni mpoa simu.
Mzuri tu, ananipatianga chakula kila siku.
Anakupatia chakula gani?
Mchele na chai.
Pata kazi nzuri, yenye mshahara mzuri, utafanya nini?
Nikipata ile ula ananilipa mzuri, nataka tu nipate pesa ninunue huko nguo niende niuze huko. Juu nimeona huko nguo ni bei rahisi, huko kwetu inakuanga bei kali. Nikipata pesa mingi na brother yangu tulipanga ku open boutique.
But Esther isn't welcome here. The large numbers of girls like her arriving from Uganda are causing tensions with Kenyan domestic workers. It's a topic that features prominently at this meeting they're holding to talk about their challenges. The discussion is being led by Khadija, a local activist and domestic worker herself.
Hawa watu wa Uganda wanatunyanyasa sana. Ukipata kazi unapiga bei mzuri, akikuja anaharibu bei. Sasa ukienda kuuliza kazi mahali, anaambiwa, wewe Mkenya, mimi sitaki Mkenya. Mimi nataka wale wa Uganda. Nyinyi wa Kenya bei yako bei yenu ni kali.
Ukiwa pale kwa nyumba, mnaona kuna tofauti ile wao wanafanya na sisi hatuwezi fanya? ama wao wanafanya sana ama usafi zaidi.
Hakuna utofauti na hakuna kazi wanajua. Lakini shida mtu anapepa mtaota paka na mchuku yake. Sasa huyu mchuku wake anakuja kuuliza tajiri nimekuletea mtu hata kama uko na rafiki yako ama mtu wako ama jirani yako kama anataka mtu wa kazi nikuletee. Sasa unapata mama akapa mtoto mchuku shangazi nani nani sasa wako tu kwa hii estate yote watu wa familia moja.
The women feel that the influx of Ugandans has only made a bad situation worse. 83% of all domestic workers in Kenya are paid below the required minimum wage. Long working hours, mistreatment, and abuse are a daily, private reality for many of them. One case that did make it into the public eye and outrage the nation is that of this Kenyan maid. Mercy Mwake emerged from a police station claiming she'd just escaped from employers who tortured and imprisoned her.
Tazingine umefanya tu makosa kidogo, labda unjatengeneza mahali vizuri vile anataka, ananichapa. Hizi alama zenye ziko kwa shingo nazo, ananingwara na magucha zake. Hiyo tuta nimefanya makosa alikuwa ananinyongea kwa ukuta. Alitumianga kikombe akanipasua hapa mara mbili. Kwa wanatupiga picha wanatuambia hizo picha wamepeana kwa gate kwa hivyo hakuna vile mtu anaweza anjificha ati atoke kwa hiyo mboma.
Mercy's case is now in court. It's been 9 months since she appeared in those shocking news reports. The judge hopes the case can be resolved through mediation. But even getting Mercy and her former employers to talk to each other is a challenge.
At least we're given time to negotiate. What's the progress?
We will pray that's possible in a month's time.
There was a lot of blame talk.
No, you cannot say that.
The judge is upset that the lawyers haven't even begun to negotiate.
Both parties agree that they will explore an out-of-court settlement because of the relationship between the complainant, Mercy Mwake, who is Mercy,
Both parties feel aggrieved. The accused deny all the charges, insisting that Mercy wasn't held against her will and that her injuries had nothing to do with them.
She was like a sister to me, and I assisted her.
We have taken her to holidays. We used to leave her in the house. She used to have the freedom, our bedrooms, everything. She used to be there, throughout.
And I don't know why they're dragging all these things.
I'm perfectly human. Maybe there are times maybe I shouted, I told her to just go leave my house. Even maybe that is the only thing I've done to her. Maybe she thought she deserved more, or maybe I brought her so close to us for her to feel like she's entitled. She's supposed to get this because, you know, I showed her from the word go, you're part of the family.
Was there never an incident where you lost your temper with her?
I've lost my tempers, yes, ma'am, but never in a million years, like, thought of hitting her or going physical. No, that is never.
The case highlights the complex relationship between employer and employee, operating behind closed doors in intimate spaces.
Enyewe nikiwaona huwa nakumbuka tu chenye walikuwa wananifanyia. Sasa hapo ndo naanzanga kusikia vibaya, najiuliza mbona walikuwa wananifanyia vitu kama hizi. Hizo tu ndo vitu huwa nawafikirie.
We also feel aggrieved because so many wrong things were said in the media. For example, they said that Mercy has never been seen since 2014. And Mercy even attended a wedding.
I don't want us to get into the merits.
Yes.
Are you people really keen on settling this matter? In fact, as early as the 20th of September 2018, nothing has happened.
Uganda negotiations have failed because parties have not even met.
These advocates are here to represent you. So I would want them to facilitate that kind of meeting. Is that okay with you?
That is my fault.
That is much proper. Why wasn't it proper before between yourselves? I want you to step out for 5 minutes.
This case might have never reached a courtroom if Mercy hadn't been supported by a charity in her quest for justice. Most cases like these are never heard, not by a judge, not by anyone.
This is for older girls.
Mm-hmm.
average, how long did the girl stay?
Like 2 years.
Edith Murogo is the founder of the Center for Domestic Training and Development. She runs the shelter where Mercy now lives and is enrolled in a training course. The center supports girls who say they've been abused or mistreated as domestic workers. There are 70 beds here, and most of the girls occupying them are between 10 and 20 years old.
Is it hard to cover all the costs?
Yeah, we fundraise a lot.
I see domestic workers as a unique group of workers. They are not just every other worker because of the conditions under which they work. They are confined. Many of them do not even have the permission to leave the employer's household. So they work in slavery-like conditions. The government should have come up with policies that are geared towards the liberation of domestic workers.
With limited resources, the shelter can only afford to help very few of the many girls in desperate need of help. The latest arrival is a 17-year-old Ugandan, brought in by the police after being caught without documentation. Her name is Scovia, the same Scovia whose grandmother is waiting for her back in Uganda. She tells a social worker it all went wrong when she failed to pay a bribe.
Wakasema mtuonesha ID zenyu. Mimi nikaambia sikuwa nimefikisha hiyo miaka. Wakatupeleka kwa police. Anti yangu. Wakaambia anti yangu. Ati mtoe 2000. Anti akasema niwape 1000 twende. Wakakata. Lakini mimi hiyo time sikuwa na pesa zinafika 1000.
Scovia had only been doing domestic work in a Nairobi home for a short while before she was arrested.
Kwa sababu shosho wangu ana uwezo, nikasema niende nitafute kazi, nijisaidie mimi mwenyewe na yeye pia nimsaidie.
Like Scovia, many Ugandan girls who come here for domestic work lack official documents. They travel alone or in small groups and disappear into private homes and informal settlements, where they're frequently preyed on by police looking for bribes. It's a potentially dangerous and exploitative world.
It looks like Esther has come up against the harsh realities of life for domestic workers here in Nairobi. We heard from her last night. She said she and her housemates have been robbed of everything they have, so I'm going to see how they are.
Esther found work in a restaurant, but the walk to and from her job is long. She leaves before dawn and returns home at night.
Msema kwamba mliibiwa.
Tulikuwa tumelala. Huyo sijui alifunguaje. Alibeba kila kitu. Walituachia tu ile bedsheet tulikuwa tumejifunika. Tukaamka asubuhi, tulipata simu zimeenda. Bage ilikuwa hapo ya Rachel pia ilienda. Na nyingine ilikuwa na nguo zake, alikuwa amenunua vitu na yeye alikuwa anaenda hii mwezi.
Rachel, the roommate we met on our last visit, had been saving to go back home to Uganda.
Aliniambia amefikisha sijui 500,000 ya kwetu. Ile ndio alichukua. Ile yote ilienda na bage. Na mimi kamwambia mimi kwanza siwezi weka pesa chini. Mimi tafadhali niweke hapa. Yangi natembea hapa. Ukiniiba utakata nini yangu bra yangu lakini huwezi kuniibia kwa bag. Sijui ilikuwa shock, sijui alipata nini. Ya katoka tu. Juu tulikuwa tunatafuta nje tunauliza kila mtu hapa. Kuna mwenye alituambia. Ya katoka tuli. Sasa sisi tulifikiria naenda kazi huko mala anafanywa mpatie pesa yake ama nini. Tukaongoja paka leo tumuone.
The robbery is a huge setback. Esther's dream of starting her own business appears to be slipping further away. At the shelter, Scovia has been told that she is being repatriated.
Scovia, when you go back there, please make a future for yourself.
You've seen how hard it is without documentation here in Kenya. Now settle down. You also need to go and say bye to the girls.
It's gonna be a hug to me.
The shelter has arranged for Scovia to return to Uganda and hopes to raise enough money to put her back in school.
Drop out of school because of school fees. Nimekuja hapa na nirudisha shule. So I'm happy for that. Very happy for that.
Many more girls who drop out of school find domestic work to be the most obvious alternative. The majority of children who enter domestic work have lost a parent or are orphaned. We're on the Ugandan side of the border with Kenya, waiting for Scovia and the social worker she traveled with to arrive.
Hey, okay. How was your journey?
After the overnight journey, it's another long drive to a boarding school near Scovia's village to find out if she can be enrolled. It's a school her family would never have been able to afford. We meet with the headmistress.
How are you going to manage this family?
That's where we are
here. You have sponsors?
Yes.
For me, I want to believe that when a girl child is educated, you have educated the nation. The class where you're going to find there very tiny kids. It is up to you to reach in that class. Your results, I cannot say that they are showing that you can't make it. But what you need to do is to work very hard.
The shelter has committed to paying for Scovia's first term at the school. Now, it's time for her to finally be reunited with her grandmother. Her grandmother doesn't own a phone, and Scovia hasn't spoken to her since she left for Nairobi.
Yeah.
I'm
a friend.
Scovia is lucky to get a shot at going back to school. But the factors that pushed her to go to Nairobi haven't gone away. If the shelter can't afford to pay for all her education, her grandmother still won't be able to help. People working in private homes play a vital economic role, but that's hardly ever recognized.
It's not an area of focus for governments, for policymakers. We have been working to professionalize domestic labor in Kenya, because we clearly see the connection between professionalization and human rights. So if it is professionalized, then it means it will be a respectable occupation like any other. And domestic work, I think, is the biggest employer of women and girls in Africa. They're the unsung heroes of our economies. It's the work that enables other work to happen.
Mercy's court case drags on. There is no resolution yet. She's now enrolled in a certification program at the shelter's training center. She never wants to work in a private home again and hopes to become a chef. Learning basic skills to a certain level increases these girls' chances of finding good employers who'll respect their work and their rights.
One glass of rice goes with how many glasses of water? Two, right? Have the garlic.
Mercy and Scovia are the exceptions. For most girls in domestic work, finding a path to better work and pay is almost impossible. By comparison, Esther's life in Nairobi is becoming more and more problematic. She has another roommate now, also a domestic worker from Uganda. Barbara was stranded after running away from a home where she says she was being mistreated. Weak and suffering from stomach ulcers, she now relies on Esther for food and shelter.
Muomba tu, ti tafadhali kama amekubali, nitoe 15, arudi ushago. Mimi huku nikuja tu kutafuta. Sasa kama yeye hataki kufanya kazi, anataka kukaa, yeye ananiletea tu hasara kwangu na plans zangu zitakuwa poa vile nataka.
Barbara says she wants to get well enough to find another job here, not go back to her village. It's a tough situation, but going back home isn't an option for Esther either.
Unajua hata baba yetu usayame. Vile unamwona hivyo, saa zingine anaweza hata wabaia lunch. Saa zingine anaweza wabaia lunch sapa mkose. Mkule sapa lunch mkose. Jie pia nakuambia kazi yangu iko chini sana. Na sasa atawaambia mjipange. Nikikaa hapa hivyo, hakuna mwenye atanilipia rent. Hakuna kukula, tafadhali wacha niende nitezeke, nipate changu nirudi. Nataka pia wajue sisi pia ni watu, lakini kukosa tu pesa. Najua sisi tukikuwa na pesa, tukikuwa tu the same. Maisha sikikuwa poa sisi wote, lakini sijui Mungu pia alipangaje. Wengine wakue maskini, wengine wakue hivyo.
There are few jobs or industries quite as complicated as one that puts young girls to work in private homes with no protections. For millions of girls and women leading already difficult lives, domestic work is often the only work they can find and the hardest work they can do.